In this video, we'll draw the graph for the linear equation y equals x minus 3. And we'll do it two ways. First, we'll put in values for x, get the corresponding value for y, and then we'll graph that. We'll graph this equation here, y equals x minus 3. Then we'll use the slope-intercept formula, y equals mx plus b, to check our work. So I like to put a 0 in for x first, because I know that's going to show up on my graph. So 0 minus 3 gives us a minus 3. If we put 1 minus 3, that's minus 2. And if we put a minus 1 and minus 3, that gives us minus 4. So these are the points that we'll graph for the equation y equals x minus 3. Let's start with 0 minus 3. So we go to x is 0, that's right here, and y is minus 3. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3. Next we have 1 and then minus 2. So we go x is 1, y is minus 2, and finally we have x is minus 1 and y is minus 4. So minus 1 and then 1, 2, 3, 4. And there's our line. You can imagine a line going through it like this. We could have done it with 2 points, but with 3 points we can catch any errors we might have made. Let's put a line right through this. And then we can put arrows on the end to show it goes out to infinity. So this is the graph for y equals mx plus b. Let's check it now with slope-intercept formula. So we have y equals mx plus b. In b, that's the y-intercept, where the line crosses the y-axis. B is negative 3 here. So we go down on the y-axis to minus 3, and that right there is where our line should go through, and it does. For m, this is the slope. So we like to think of it this way. There's a 1 in front of the x. We don't write it, but it's there. That's our m. In 1, we could write it as 1 over 1. It's the same thing. It's still 1. But now we can consider this rise over run. So we'll rise 1 and go over 1. So we go to the y-intercept. We rise 1, go over 1. And then from there, we rise 1, go over 1. And you can see these points, they're all on our line. Likewise, we could go in the opposite direction. We could go down 1 and then over 1 to the left. Again, from there, down 1, over 1 to the left. And again, all of these points are on the line y equals x minus 3. So that's it. This is the graph for y equals x minus 3. And this is Dr. B. Thanks for watching.